checked his phone to see if he's cheating and found screenshots of me cheating. Oh my God. It's not funny. It's not funny. That's terrible. But I mean, it explains a lot. That's probably why you think that he's cheating, is because you feel guilty on your own.
Am I the drama? I don't think I'm the drama.
This was recent too. June 20th, 2022 at 4:33 a.m. Sometimes you really do just be up thinking about things, you know? Blossom got. I was being a dick to a taxi driver tonight and didn't pay my fare. So I done a runner and left my phone in the car because I'm a stupid bleep. And this is the taxi driver writing this status. That's so funny. At first I was like, where is this going? And why would you ever, first of all, why would you ever do that? But why would you ever admit to it in a Facebook post? We have our answer. We have our answer. That's what happens. That is instant justice. I love that. Well, they got a new phone, so you could probably sell that. Make more money than the fare would have been.
Got the dogs out.
That's so funny. Aw, why did they always, like, it's always the dogs that are working that look so cute when you can't pet them, but you want to, but they're working. Love little dogs, little working dogs. It's so cute. This is hilarious. I mean, I bet some of those people were running just because other people were running and they just felt like they were supposed to do that. But not all of them. That's definitely for sure. Yep. That's what happens. Also, risky business, trying to mess with a Canadian goose. Those things are vicious, they are scary, and they don't care, okay?
They will come for you.
They're crazy though, they really are. I don't know, they're, what's the word I'm looking for? They like confrontation. Wow, Canada geese really are Karens, now that I'm realizing. Oh no, I'm nervous. That's what happens. That's what happens. You can't rage out like that, you know? That's what happens. Yikes, that would suck. His reaction is exactly what I would do. Just like, oh, I'm an idiot. At least it didn't hit the PlayStation though. It was pretty close. I don't know. I guess they both suck. They're both expensive. I don't know what to tell ya. There's no good. It's all bad. I tried to like look on the bright side, but it didn't work.
This woman was following us around the store after having a go at us for using the price check, and she had to wait.
If you're making disturbance, actually, I'm allowed to.
Story time.
Down in Australia, down under. I love that accent. That's the greatest accent on planet. That's such a beautiful accent. I love it.
You know, right? Leave us alone.
Yeah, it's alone. That's Australia. You can hear that. Alone.
No.
No. Trying to master it, but it's quite difficult, actually. For shopping, I feel like, you know, sometimes passions can be high, especially like a Black Friday in America. You guys go crazy. Americans go crazy for that, don't they? Black Friday in America? We have that here, but it's not as crazy. It's just not the same. You guys go nutty for it. I've seen people get like TVs for like 80% off. Great deal, I guess, but to throw down and hurt each other? I don't know. My rule of thumb is for shopping, because as well as a firefighter, lawyer, doctor, and the many other things I said, I'm also your accountant. Hi, how are you? For me, for shopping and stuff, I'm a pretty simple guy. Like I don't ask for much, especially with groceries or anything like that. I'm very simple. Like I got a very simple wardrobe, everything. But if I have to ask the price of something, my rule is like, hey, if I gotta ask the price, I probably don't need it anyway. That's just my thing. Probably don't need it.
Did he just like not notice, or I don't know, sometimes people get so caught up in like what they want to do. Also, who's racing in a truck? I don't know a lot about cars or going fast, but it just seems like a bizarre choice to race in. But maybe trucks are just really fast. I don't know. Let me know. Car people, enter the chat and let me know. Are trucks just really fast and a really good racing vehicle? I don't know. Also, why do people try and race on roads? Yeah, I mean, why are there so many people in a parkade though? Why? Not really a cool hangout spot, to be honest. And it seems really annoying, like it's really hard to drive by, which is kind of the whole point of, well, I guess the whole point is to park, but still, there's, you know, the before and after of that. Yeah, that really is instant justice if I've ever seen it.
That's not the way the protocol is here at the beach. You can't just stand there. People are waiting in line. We've all been waiting in line.
We've been waiting in line.
Well, they need to circle around like we have.
Oh my gosh. Why does everyone think that they can just stand in a spot to hold a parking spot? Especially like she said, when there's a line to get a parking spot? Absolutely not. No, ma'am.
You need to move. You need to move. You need to move.
Okay, well, if I have to get the lifeguard, I will.
That's left.
It's just not happening. And then the fact that she leaves when she goes to get the lifeguard, because she knows she's wrong. That's the thing. She thought that they were just gonna like, you know, whatever, be like, it's not worth it, but sometimes you gotta stick to your guns. Everyone was a Karen here, but that doesn't mean that some people were in the wrong. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you have to be a Karen. Yeah, like what the hell? Why did she not realize either? Like just try to giggle your way through when you clearly upset somebody?
Ew, David.
Cause like imagine roles are reversed. It's a thing, people just don't think about it. Like it's not okay either way. Both are just inappropriate. Also you're at like Disney or something. Like why would you even, it's just a weird place to even think that that's acceptable in the first place. But like you can't do that. Would you want somebody to do that to you? Probably not. People forget that it goes both ways. It's crazy too.
You can't wait. Sign says no eating and drinking. You don't get it? You don't get it. You must be stupid. I've seen people like you on TV.
Oh my gosh. Imagine like being pressed over somebody eating a burrito. Like the only thing that I would be mad about is that I don't get a bite.
Yes, please, can we get a policeman on board here? We got somebody dining in the first car. Number 356. He's dining, eating on the train? Eating on the train?
Like, imagine trying to call the police to the car. Because you're like, well, there's a sign right there that says no eating or drinking. Sir, relax and mind your own business. I hope that burrito was good. Oh, people just love to get in other people's business for no reason at all.
Because I'm pathetic.
Wild Karen on wet cement.
Here we see a wild Karen. Phone out, standing on uncured, just finished cement. Taking pictures of wood that is not in the correct position for her liking.
What the heck? Man, I almost wish that the cement would like fully dry and she's just like stuck there now, like she can't move. It's just like, there you are, like, oh, but imagine the homeowner. It's like from now on, like your home comes with this Karen. It's like, that's it. Like you just have this Karen in your driveway now, like forever standing there. Damn, that'd be kind of funny actually.
And this lady decides to pull in from this side, trying to jump the line, because she said she's been waiting for a while.
Mm.
cool, but
yeah,
you
I'm
even...
not trying to hit you. I'm just trying to cut her off because she's.
Don't cut in the drive-through line. We're all trying to get a junior chicken here, okay?
She ain't been waiting in line. That's not how works, ma'am. There is a line. Mm-hmm.
You can wait in the line, Karen.
There is a line.
You on camera, bitch. I'm more beautiful than you, bitch.
I'm more beautiful than you, bitch. I'm more beautiful than you, bitch.
Cool. Wait in line, though.
That's somebody who like knew that they f***ed up and like they were trying to, you know, play it off cool. Apparently, we see a lot of drive-thru freakouts. People are angry in the drive-thru. I don't know, I'm kind of just chilling. Like, you're sitting in your car, listening to music, like.
Yes, I do, because I'm hungry.
I'm not in a rush. Well, maybe you are, but that's why they're angry. And I like that this one says language alert. You guys are worried about the language, you're f***ing here. You're in bad hands.
Only in America.
Is the same size as that's your
dog.
I don't care. That's your dog using the bathroom.
My dog was not doing that, sir.
Ma'am, you're just pick it. It's not. I'm not trying to.
I'm picking that up.
I'm not trying to make a loud noise and make a case about it. Just pick it up.
It's big. Like, why don't you pick it up?
I'm not picking. That's not my dog. I don't even have a dog. Just can you please pick it up? I'm sorry. I'm talking to you respectfully. Can you just pick it up?
I want you to pick it up.
Oh my God, ma'am, your dog
it's
is
your
using
dog.
The restroom despite it being small. Just
yeah, guys, this is a pet peeve of mine for sure. Like, it's your dog, which means it's your responsibility, and you are taking your dog, maybe you're taking your dog for a carry right now, but I imagine that prior to filming, you were taking your dog for a walk. You knew that your dog on said walk was going to do their business. Where's your bag? This should be part of the process right now. Your dog goes to the bathroom, you pick it up, boom, everybody's chill. I'm totally on the side of the dude right now. Like, lady, it's your dog, pick up the crap.
I think the funniest part of that, and the music will probably be cut out for you guys, but in the actual clip, it's playing Pump Up the Jam. Well, this guy's just going to town on a car. No worries. I mean, he had the right music behind this act. Oh my God. Jeez Louise, he really didn't want to let this Karen pass. No worries.
Look, she's crying because I hit her bumper away.
You hit my bumper.
Le
pegué. You hit my bumper, stupid.
Oh.
Stupid ass.
God bless you. You have a good day. You have a good day. You have a good day.
What?
Ah, shut up, Karen. Karen.
Okay, hold up. Did he actually hit her bumper though? Because like if he actually hit her car and then he was like responding like this, being like, Karen, like, shut up, like, blah, blah. Like, I hear what she's saying, you know, like, she is being rude as all holy hell. But like, if somebody hit my car and then started filming me and acting like this, then I'd also be like, yo, like, what the hell? Like, what the hell's going on right now? Maybe he didn't even hit her bumper though. Cause like, I didn't see right at the, like, did you see if they hit, Chris? Did they hit? That's key information here, man. Like, if he actually hit her car and then like is refusing to do anything about it and just is gonna leave, then I almost understand how she's responding. But if he didn't hit her car at all and then she's just freaking out, then yeah, like Karen, absolutely.
Sunita, you can't park your car here. I've actually contacted House and Son. You can't use it. You can't use it as a parking spot.
That's my car.
It's not your car.
It is my car.
You don't drive.
Oh my gosh. You can't just park your car wherever you want.
You don't know.
Are you calling me what? You are so rude.
Oh my God, you can film it. No,
you cannot have people just parking their car here to go to work. To go to work. It'll be reported. Thank you. Thank you, Sarmite. Don't be so rude.
Man, some people really will just park. They'll just go, yep, this is where my car is now. Oh God, just a bad situation.
If your ass don't leave me the motherfucker alone, girl, I go to jail in this motherfucker.
Oh.
And I'm dead, the motherfucker.
A wise man who knows his own limitations.
Where's your husband?
What? It's a wise man who knows his own limitations. And what are you saying? Like, what are you talking about, lady? She just hits him with like the double whammy like that, like boom. It's like, and then like she hits him with that, and then she goes like seriously, like philosophical with it, like a wise man knows his limitations. Like, we are doing two separate things right now, man. Like, your message is not coming across to me, lady. Like, leave me alone.
I'm sorry, I can't. We're closed.
I need my phone fixed today.
I can't. We're closed. I don't have enough time.
I can't go without my phone. How much you want? I'll pay you whatever you want. What you
it's
need?
Not, gonna... It's not about money.
I'll pay you extra for your time.
It's not about...
I need my phone. I can't go without it.
Part of me that feels like this is just like staged a little bit. I'm getting that energy, so.
We don't, what kind of phone is it? We don't even have the screen for it. I can't do this tonight. I'm sorry.
I have to do it. I cannot.
I can't.
You have to fix my phone. I can't without my phone.
I don't have that screen. It's impossible.
Well, I'll get one. I don't care what you gotta do. Get my phone fixed.
Monday is the earliest.
No, Monday. I can't wait.
Okay. You have to leave. I'm sorry. And
no,
take
I'm
your.
Not. I'm leaving. You pissed me. You have to.
There's like part of me that feels like this is fake. I feel like I have a good radar for those sorts of things, but maybe I don't. But if not, I think it's probably good that her phone broke for a little bit because she'll see the freedom you have without it. Like last night I plugged my phone in at like 6 because it died and kind of forgot that it existed for a while. I do that a lot. Everyone thinks I'm ignoring them, but really I'm ignoring everyone. Oops.
So you were leaving the stop sign?
I already left the stop sign.
So did you have the right? He had the right of way, but you smashed it down.
No. Okay. I was out of Eubanic on where the Valvoline is.
Here.
He goes, you hit me, bitch. You better pull over.
Okay.
That was his exact words, and he was being smart, and then I got it. I am sorry.
Okay.
I take Cymbalta. I'm ready to explode.
What?
And I did not take my pill today.
Oh no.
I broke many people's arms. And
she didn't take her pill.
This is gonna look awesome on YouTube.
I'll tell you right now, mister, that freaking shows up on YouTube, I will find you.
Oh. Oh man, she didn't take her pill today, guys. Wow, whatever are we gonna do? I guess we're just gonna crash into people and explode. That's what's gonna happen. Wow. I wonder her reaction when this did show up on YouTube, because guess where we are right now, guys? We're on YouTube. Hello, everybody. Welcome up. We're on YouTube right now. And yeah, you made it, lady. You made the cut. I wonder what her reaction was. Wow. Damn. That's, yeah. Take your pill, I guess.
Well, you should be.
For what?
Well, you should be. How much can I do?
Grandma. Someone come get the grandma.
I'm buying it all.
Fine.
I'm buying it all. I am going to buy it all. I'm going to give it away to all these people.
Grandma, that now, grandma, that's not nice behavior. My grandma's not like that.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
I am not ashamed.
Grandma,
of
wait, grandma, go home, grandma.
Yeah, you're really standing up for them, yelling at them.
Oh, and they take them all around the country, and you should see how they live.
Yeah. My grandma's the best. She's caring and loving to me and everybody. She's the best. I love my grandma. She's the best. That grandma needs, grandma needs to go back home. Someone let her out of the home. Who let grandma out of the home? Get her in the bus. Take her back home. She wants to go to CVS? Too bad. You're going back, grandma. That's it. Why are you going to pick on a street vendor, man? Let them do their thing. What are they really bothering you that much? You know, I don't know. Here in Canada, there's all kinds of like events for street vendors, specifically so they don't have, I guess, loiter in front of stores, which if you're loitering in front, I guess that's not okay. But still, grandma and grandma, give a guy a break, man. Oh, we're at the Best Buy. Uh-oh.
Oh, no, he's recording me, but you're...
I would like you to delete that right now.
No, he's recording me.
I want him to delete it because he pointed it at my face.
No, he's recording me.
I have your license plate.
No, for sure.
I want to see you delete it right now. Right now!
I don't understand what the fear is.
He's recording me. Your wife comes in our shot. I don't understand. No disrespect. I'm sorry. You got to see her like this, dog. It's just, there's real stuff going on. She's calling the cops because we're filming. Let's go, bro.
Yeah, and they're getting ready to leave, and they have a
I mean, I it's hard for me to say that because I'm on camera literally every day. I love being on camera, and the camera loves me too.
A masterpiece.
At least I hope it does. Ooh, adding 10 pounds. No, but,
I like being on camera. I feel comfortable on camera, completely comfortable on camera. Whether it's because I have the experience here and being an actor and other stuff I do, I don't know. But I just don't understand why people get so like enraged by being on camera. Yeah, I get sometimes we don't want to be on camera. Sometimes when I wake out of bed in the morning and someone's like, hey, let's take your picture. Someone always wants to take your picture when you're never looking your best, naturally. But I don't know. I just don't get it. Especially in 2022, in this modern age where there's a camera, literally, you're on camera, like that's life. 25 years ago, I completely understand. But now, like, man, you're on probably like 50 security cameras in that parking lot. Like, that's how it goes. I don't know. Okay. Yeah. But you can just. Oh man, traffic ones are always just weird to me. It's like I always say, man, once something, just keep her going. It's a road. There's no reason to stop and get out like that. There just really isn't. But you just gotta go. It's very simple. But, don't. My whole thing too is when you yell at somebody on the road like that, there's no way someone's gonna go home to their family like, oh man, you should have seen what happened to me. This guy told me off and he was right. You know, I was doing the wrong thing. Nobody goes home and does that. Nobody. Everyone goes home and goes, oh, you wouldn't believe this. Jack I was dealing with. Everybody does that.
Jack. So I'm a jack.
No point in yelling, just go home. Wait, what you got there, fella? It's your bad parking if I've ever seen it. You got a, what is that, a Corvette? Looks like a nice white Corvette. Older model, maybe, let's say, mid to late 2000s. Parked quite poorly in probably a restaurant parking lot, so not good. And then the guy, it was that Jeep, Grand Cherokee, an older one? I think that's what it is. I know my cars, sure, I know cars. Looks like a 90s model, late 90s model, perhaps. Pretty sure it's a 4x4, at least it looks like it might be. He's got a higher suspension, maybe. And he's in a truck, so he's saying, you know what? The curb, I got bigger wheels, no problem. So he parks on the curb diagonally to that car, just to, because if you do more bad, that cancels out the bad, and then there's good. Right? That's how it works, Dad, yeah. That makes sense. That's not how it works.
Oh, so we did.
What?
Idiot.
What the heck? Imagine, like, getting a tan, and then you gotta dodge a horse. What? That was, everything about that was the most chaotic, but also at the same time, the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. Like, that water is so gorgeous, that sand, but then it's just absolute chaos. The last thing I was expecting was to see a horse galloping away. That's so funny. Wow, what a fever dream.
Oh, women looks items around grocery store and Instagram believes helps fortify your immune system. Yeah, I've seen that before. Yeah, it don't do that. But put it this way, when people say germs are gonna help your immune system, as your doctor, put it up here, I'm your doctor. I'm gonna put it, maybe give me a stethoscope or something, I'm your doctor. You're right, strengthening your immune system is important, and you know, being around certain things of course can help. You know, that's what you have an immune system for. But sometimes your immune system needs a little bit of help. It needs, you know, it needs a good old, you know, and sometimes reducing the amount of the onslaught of germs and viruses that are around is a good thing, because I don't think people realize how many germs there really are around us. That, you know, that plot in that movie with Tom Cruise and the aliens come down, but they just end up leaving and dying because they got sick. It probably would happen. There's a lot of crazy stuff here on planet Earth. But what I'm getting at is, even without this lady licking everything, licking it like a lollipop.
Just licking it like a lollipop. Like a lollipop.
There's already germs on that stuff. A lot of stuff gets shipped, so that means it's touched multiple hands. You don't know what they wash their hands. It's probably sat in dusty containers. It's went overseas. You're kind of right, but you don't need to lick it. I like my ice cream unlicked, thank you very much. I like my salty crackers not licked. I like them nice and dry, thank you very much.
Don't touch my car. Don't touch my car. You shouldn't be trying to get into my car. I'm trying to order. Please go back to your car. Okay, well, you just were. You were just trying to get in the car. No, please, please, goodbye.
That's because you honked at
him. You can't do anything about that, can you? Yep, that's what you can do. Let me off.
Confronting somebody in a drive-thru. I can't say I've been there. Can't say I relate to that one. Where are they? Can't tell where they are. That doesn't look like it's a Canadian restaurant. I can't tell what that is exactly. But was it say favorites? Maybe it's a Wendy's, maybe? It's a Wendy's? It's like tacos? Maybe it's like Del Tacos, they call it? Del Taco? We don't have those here. We've only got Taco Bell here. I don't know. I don't know if Del Taco is worth fighting over. Especially in a drive-thru, you're stuck there. You just gotta like, they're the worst person ever. And then you gotta sit there and just like awkwardly stare at the car for another like 5 minutes while they get their order.
I'm built different.
Built different.
That's very funny. I was thinking that. I was like, I feel like I could probably crack an egg right here. I don't know why I would. Seems like kind of a waste of an egg, but I think I could. Like, if he did that with like a watermelon, my mind would have been blown. But like an egg? I don't know. Gravity can crack an egg, you know? Drop it.
It's a train and they got all the shit. What, they got food everywhere? I can't tell. It's a weird picture. What the hell's going on? I don't know. Don't destroy a public space. And I ride the train every day, and I make sure, even though I'm a big guy, just squeeze in a little bit, just a little squeezing, and then make sure everybody can get on. And I don't have Cheeto dust everywhere. It's so weird. That's not a parking spot. That's not a parking spot. Although the one beside it is free now, so maybe, I guess that wasn't free before. Black Friday, baby. Hey, Black Friday sales. Gotta get those sales. Gotta get that TV. Gotta get my Pokemon cards. Gotta get my extra large American size family size of potato chips. Let's go and park there. What a stupid thing to do. The cart guy shows up, he can't put his carts in. Oh, that's not good. You're probably gonna get in some trouble. Although the tow truck might have issues getting in there. So maybe it's a five-head play, actually. I don't know. I won't try it though. I promise I won't.
The cars are not supposed to go over the escalator in the mall. You gotta park the car in the parking garage. Sorry, the laws of Minnesota say so.
I don't know. That's just how do you do that? Touch wood. There's no wood to touch. There's wood. Standing on touch wood. I've never been in a car accident. Don't ever want to be in one. I don't know if it's because I went to driving school. Like a square, but it taught me a lot. Actually, I hate to say it, I learned more in driving school than I probably learned in my 12 years of education in regular school. So keep your foot on the brake, look well ahead, and stay calm.
Man, don't start something you can't finish.
You better go! Get out! You don't want
Because, like, realistically, if the guy wasn't saying things like exit the premises and instead was just like giving the same energy back and was aggressive and tried to start a physical altercation like she was. Exit the premises. That girl is a Karen, that's for sure. I don't think it would have gone well for her. I'm just saying. I think she would have regretted all of the things that she said leading up to that point. So, just don't start something you can't finish. Is that's my reaction.
What the hell is going on? We've been sitting out there for 15 minutes, man. What the hell's going on? I don't want you to spit all over my sandals, but we've been sitting out there for 15 minutes. I'm sorry, what? I don't have your seat. I've been sitting out there for 15 minutes, man.
And 15 minutes really isn't that long.
I'm so sorry, but what was your order?
Two sandwiches, man. Just two sandwiches.
You can't. You have to give them the information. You can't just complain and then leave. Well, I mean, you can. It's probably preferable for everyone in the establishment if you just leave. But, like, why even bother complaining if you're just not gonna even let them get the thing? I can understand how you'd be like, I feel like things should be ready by now. Like, that's pretty reasonable, I would say. You know, if it's a fast food place. But like, you could just go and ask, and then they seemed pretty nice and like willing to help you out. So, I don't know. Just two sandwiches, man. It's just kind of funny because you sounded like so defeated at the end. And I don't think it's funny when people are defeated. It was just made me laugh.
Karen, go burr.
You guys just took my car. Nobody called you. Nobody called you. Call the cops. I'm shit on this.
There's both signs on the side of the street, no parking, farting.
What? Is that your car? I don't think that's her car, guys. I don't believe that that is her car. And yeah, lady, if that's not your car, then no, you're not allowed to sit on it. You gotta get off. You know, what is it with these people and thinking that regardless of the situation, it's like, boom, they own it. You know, they're always like, this is my property. And I'm like, but it's just like, it's not, you know, like you're just not allowed to do that. And then they always start throwing stuff out. Like, it's like, oh, like I have the right, like blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, you have no idea what your rights are. Like, you just have no idea. And you're saying those words to make yourself sound smart, but you just don't actually know.
Get the f*** out of here, you son of a You know, you're not supposed to be, I'm a sheriff. I work for Shetwood. Get your ass out of here. If you got license, you son of a
This lady's savage. I don't even know what she's upset about, but she is.
It says, I mean, I just want a private property. Man.
Oh, no, no, hell, you can't fish. You don't know how to fish. You don't even wear the right kind of clothes. You got damn stupid shoes on anyway. Where'd you get them ugly
boots? Roasted, bro.
On a rampage. She's going off. Okay, I mean, you tell them. This lady is wild. Wow. I don't even know if she's a Karen. I think she's just old. Well, you can still be a Karen when you're old. That's true, but, you know, I'll be less angry at her because she's so old.
I'm telling you to get out of my face.
I need the name. No, it froze.
Owner. This is privacy owner.
It's private communication.
I already told you that. So private. Get out of my face.
Excuse you.
I need you to leave.
I'm not leaving.
Ma'am, I need you to get out of my face.
I'm not leaving.
Get out of my face.
Oh my gosh. Like, why when somebody's telling you to leave an establishment, do people just say, no, I'm not gonna leave? Like, sorry, you don't get to choose.
Get out of my face.
Stop it.
Are you gonna hit me?
Stop it.
Are you gonna hit me?
I'm gonna call the police.
Get out of my face. Ma'am, get out of my face.
Don't touch my phone.
Get out of my face.
Do not touch my phone.
Get out of my face.
This is a business. This is a private property, okay? If I tell you to leave, goodbye. Goodbye. And if you don't, you know who's gonna come? The police. And guess what? They've got other things to do than deal with Karens, okay? Just because a lady wants to wave her phone around. They're busy. Just leave. Just go to the next store. Tell us.
You're not welcome here.
This is my car on our driveway.
Oh.
Then why can you guys do it then? Yeah, and this is ours. So what's your point? You guys park all day there. What are you talking about? This is my driveway. I park
it back where the parking is.
Then why don't you go back there and park there too? This is my side of the property. I don't have to park.
Oh my god. It's what did I just say?
Yeah, the cop is coming out. So, yeah, they're gonna tell you to move your car.
What did I just say, guys? This is my property. No, this is my property. No, this is my property. Like, whose freaking property is that? I feel like we just all need to, like, draw lines everywhere. There needs to be, like lines between everyone's stuff. And if you go in my line, let's say they're kindergartners, you know? It's like the game that you play with your sibling in the car, you know? It's like, this is my side of the freaking car right now. You get your hand over here, and then you do it to mess with them, and then it's like they get pissed off. But that's what literally is happening right now, guys. Like, whose property is it? You know, and this is a game of inches, too. Like, you already know. If she's on their property by a little bit, it's like, oh, you're on my property. You have to move your car. I don't even know who is the Karen here, because it's like, whose property is whose? You know, we need lines. We do.
I spent $35 for something I can't use. That's your salesman sold me. Know it damn well.
Matt, I can't hear what the employee said, but I could definitely hear what that Karen was absolutely screaming about.
I can't give it!
She paid $35 for this thing she can't use. I'm like, that's really just not the way to ask for a refund or store credit or an exchange for something you can use. Lady, nobody's gonna help you if you're leaning over the counter and screaming at them.
You need to get off of your property.
You know what? How, shall I call security?
Do you want me off of your property?
I don't want you walking around doing
this. We are on break, ma'am.
You are in my line of vision doing nothing.
We are on break.
You are worthless. You are not doing anything.
Okay.
You are walking around.
We are on break.
Like this.
Do you not see him eating?
So it seems like they were like hired to do some work or something like that. And then she's mad that they need to also eat food because they're humans who need sustenance.
You know him what? Eating food? I don't care.
Do you not see him eating? We are on break. We're on break. You want me off your property?
Call security.
You, okay.
Do you want me to?
Do it, please. Please, do it.
You need to get out of here.
Get off your property?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, thank you.
You've hired people to work, you want them to, you know, do an efficient job. It's your money. I respect that. I appreciate that. But at the same time, like, wouldn't you want, like, to hire people who, like, get a break, to eat food, are having a good time while they work? Like, you know, people who are just enjoying their job. I feel like normally when people are, like, enjoying their job, the work is better.
Hey, what's your name?
My name's Tyler.
Tyler?
Yes.
Am I staying at your job, boy? Okay, enjoy it. Oh, man.
Are you hoping to sign up for another sip and save, ma'am?
Oh, no, I'm not. I just want that stupid drink because I'm gone.
Okay.
And don't enjoy.
Okay.
I'm going to enjoy getting you fired because I'm talking to those ladies. Shut up.
1:30.
Oh, my goodness.
It's against the law. You cannot film a citizen. Look at me.
Ma'am, we have security cameras.
I don't care. Hey, sue me.
Ma'am,
boy.
I am so tired.
I'm gonna ask you to leave. If you come back, I'm calling the cops.
Oh, wow. Yeah, for real. Then go to bed? Question mark? Yeah, I think that this one really needs a nap, guys. She is in desperate need of taking a little snuzz.
I just pulled into McDonald's and this lady is holding this spot in front of this van for her husband to cut us all in the drive-thru.
No, you're not a car. Get out of there.
So she can get her McDonald's first. There is a line for a
people are so dumb. That's like, lately we've been seeing a lot of people holding parking spots too with just their body. Like, this is the place where cars go. Also, you can wait in line like everyone else. Your husband can wait in line like everyone else. If I could stand in every line for Taylor, I absolutely would, but unfortunately, that's not how life works. The guy's gonna have to wait around sometimes. Sorry, but it's not my fault.
Wait, so maybe just, I am drunk. Am I?
Yes, we just have to sell here.
Why were they keeping it? Okay? They removed me from the casino because I'm too drunk.
The man went into the fifth dimension. The shirt really adds to whatever is going on here, to be quite honest. Like, that's quite the shirt. Also, he got kicked out of a casino. Gambling is bad. It all, you know, intertwines with each other. It's all related.
I knew you were trouble as soon as I saw you.
I'd ask that you please, this guy. I would ask that you please stay 6 feet from me.
Stay away from this Ray Payton, mother.
This guy like pulled the Uno reverse card on death.
I'd ask.
Stay away from him. Stay away from him. This is a race baby. This is a race.
At later. This point, you just stay away, okay? Or I'm gonna call the police. I will call the police.
Go ahead.
I like this. This guy, well, I don't like this. There's clearly an issue here, but this guy's just hammered on the beach, vibing a little too hard.
you're publicly intoxicated, that's clear. Public intoxication is a crime. It's a felony, so.
Stay away from him. Stay away from him.
What were they even doing? Why was this guy also... Death in flip-flops is hilarious. I love that. But why were they on the beach? What were they doing? What were they there for?
I got a lot of questions.
Karen is a white girl! Karen is a white girl!
I don't know what they're saying.
Big Zoo, shut up! Oh, hey!
You're a champion! You're a champion!
Yeah, don't know what I'm saying. Love the British chants. Love the soccer chants. They're on an airplane, it looks like. And she was probably the one kind of, shut up. What is this, a zoo? Shut up. Yeah, sorry, Karen. You can't. You don't control the plane. You're not the pilot. You don't get to control that. I don't know what they were saying. Someone let me know in the comments what they were saying. And it's gonna be so obvious, but dude, you know what? You think I have a hard time understanding accents. I don't know why. I do so many of them. You think I know? I don't know.
That's so scary. That was the scariest thing I've ever seen. That was like a real life horror movie. Ooh, I did not like that. Ew, what a creep. Classic.
Got it all over my fingers.
This is a classic video.
This is tonight's dinner.
Commitment.
Word.
What year is this from? Man, this is a classic video. And it's just like the most, this is what teenagers used to do. I saw this as a kid.
Oh, he's calling his friends over.
It's good. The
asshole.
Oh, God. He's going to be so
upset. Excellent, dude. Excellent, man. Excellent, excellent. Yeah.
Stuff like this when I was a kid. Oh, man. Oh, the poor seagulls, though. I'm not for doing this, but the video's good. We did it one time and we can just leave it alone. You know what I'm saying? Just leave that in the past.
Working third shift at a hotel dealing with it's like for part to wait for it.
I got three complaints that you're knocking on doors. Do you have a room?
Yeah.
What's your room?
204.
204, so why are you on the third floor?
I got locked up here. These doors are locked, man.
What are you talking about? You can walk right out the store.
Oh man, this is just like a terrible situation to be in.
The doors have locks on them.
All right, come on, you gotta get off the third floor.
Who said I knocked on the door?
Three different calls.
What were the rooms?
I'm not gonna tell you that. Get off the third floor, please, before I kick you out.
Did I knock on the door?
Hey, get the f*** out right now. Go.
I didn't knock
get
on the door.
Get the f*** out of here. Go.
Sorry, man. I'm
no.
Sorry.
Oh my god, just like the absolute worst response you could possibly have. Working at a hotel, like, there's probably some crazy stories. Hey you, if you work at a hotel, let us know what it's like. Is it fun? Is it stressful? Is it weird? Give us a little insight. I wanna work at a hotel.
We have somebody running the station, please.
That's wild. I mean, man, like, it's gonna cost you a lot more money now.
Young guy in here putting the machines about, he's smashing them up. We need assisted surgery.
This is bad. Oh.
No, it's Betfred's in Cowley. That's where. Betfred's Temple Square, Cowley. One second.
This is crazy. He was mad. That move at the end. He meant business. Don't gamble. Don't gamble. It's just bad. I know it's fun, but it's bad. It's bad and it's addictive and it's scary and risky. I'm not a gambler. I'm not a risk taker. I like to play it safe.
10 minutes for a single sandwich and I'm about to
miss a what?
So I appreciate it if you could put a cap in your step. Doesn't take that long to
Well, if it don't take that long, why don't you do it yourself? Yeah, if you're that much of a rush, why?
So again, you don't
want
to make sandwiches? Because there's billions of places
to go.
What are you giving it away and trying it out? I paid for it.
Stupider. That sounds even stupider.
That was nice. Thank you.
There's no way anyone behind that counter is gonna go, you know what, that lady that yelled at me today and berated me and made me feel like I was nothing, she's right, I gotta make those sandwiches faster. Nobody's gonna take that advice off the chin, Chief, because you're not. It's not it. Yeah, talk to the Chief, he said it's not it. That's it. That's all there is to it. You're not, that's not how it works. Oh, people, man, I don't know. People are crazy.
Oh my God, they have guns.
Go, 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 go,
no,
go,
no,
go.
No, 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 please, 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 what? Please, please, please. Please, what?
Dang, that's crazy. They were so scared. You could tell that was like genuine, like real fear.
Please, please, please. Please,
no, 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 no. Okay, wait. Hey, no.
Please. No,
no, no,
no,
no,
no, no, no, no,
no,
no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no,
no, no, no,
no,
no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, it's okay. He's got his hand on his shoulder. They shook hands. He's like, no, no problem. He's like, okay, we're just making sure everything's good, all right?
What's your name?
Philip.
No problem. May I speak English a little?
A little.
Don't be scared. Help is on the way. Help has arrived. I don't fucking know.
Gosh.
Call the police.
Call the police.
I'm standing right here until they get here.
We're leaving.
My husband's a lawyer. He's
You're gonna get hit.
Not your lawyer.
Oh my gosh. Wow, this was wild.
Okay. Bye. Okay. Bye.
Back up, back up. Just back up. She'll leave.
Yeah, she'll leave. Move. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Oh.
Leave, leave, leave. Back up, back up, back up, back up, back up, back up. You're crazy.
No, I'm not. You know what? You guys are terrible. You're generation.
Bye.
I just like don't know why when everyone's in like a situation like this where they're freaking out and like preventing people from leaving and general bad behavior, potentially illegal activities, they like to bring up their family members, you know? Like that lady on the plane who's like, my brother's a sniper or something like that. And then this lady's like, my husband's a lawyer. I'm like, I
do not care.
He could be Annalise Keating and he still can't get you out of standing behind somebody's car and preventing them from leaving. I'm pretty sure that's a crime. I don't think you're allowed to do that. Also, no way her husband's Annalise Keating. No one's Annalise Keating. If you know, you know. Man, that's crazy. I mean, I don't think you should be blocking the street, but I also don't think screaming at the guy is gonna get him to move any faster.
He got out on her.
Damn, this motherfucker.
Just personally. I think it's a bad tactic. She should try something else and see if it works. Like going another way or something.
Is this your store?
I am a customer!
So am I!
Out of this store.
So am I! I'm a customer too, Becky.
Oh my god. That lady needs to learn how to chill out. Jesus Christ. I would have kicked her out of the store so fast. I would have been like, no, 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 no one above the age of like 10 is allowed to scream and cry in my store. Absolutely not. See you later. No, 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 lady. You're way too old to be doing that.
He was mad that I parked on the side of the road to get me something to eat.
Look at you about to fire your dumb stupid. Go ahead, call the police. I'm be right here waiting. I ain't going nowhere.
That was a short but hot encounter. Everyone was angry. Oh my gosh. He was mad that I parked on the side of the road to get me something to eat. Like, were you not supposed to park there? And also, is he the parking guy? I don't know. I mean, listen, if it's a spot where a car is supposed to go, I see no issue. You know, if it's a human where a car is supposed to go, different story.
Meanwhile, at my local Family Dollar, Karen ended up calling the cops on worker and it backfire. Ha ha, like the cartoon.
Oh boy.
You can call whoever you want, you bitch.
What? This is at a Family Dollar? Oh my god.
I'm taking it. Get somebody up.
Yep. Yeah, that'll help. That'll definitely help.
I got money, I got money. I don't need to steal it. You got me mixed up with somebody else. No, no.
My brain. Wow, it's ridiculous to me. It is totally, and then she called the police after she's doing this. She called the police. Imagine the police showing up to this, just being like, wow, this sucks. I came into law enforcement to like help and save people, and here I am. Brutal.
I don't know why this entitled Boulder attitude has people thinking that they own bike racks and stuff, but you need to stop touching my stuff. And I mean, there's plenty of other space
can
here.
You
don't
what
own
I'm
this.
Saying?
I can absolutely hear
oh,
what you're
okay,
saying. You just
I,
butted
says,
in.
Is
Dude.
That your bike?
Yes,
and
it is.
And you asked me if it was mine.
Yeah, because you're like, I always park on the end. That doesn't matter to me. There's plenty of other space here. We're the same type of person, man. You're no better than me. I'm no better than you. You don't own the end of the rack.
So
that doesn't mean you can walk in and grab
I've been doing this for 40 years.
It doesn't matter how long you've been doing it. That's what's wrong with you Boulder people, man. You're so entitled. You think because you've been doing something for a long time, you can, like, you have the right to touch other people's
an unhappy person.
You sound like an unhappy person, says the guy who is upset that he didn't get his spot on the bike rack. Like, I'm just saying, it's a little ironic, mister. If that really is the case, that you were upset about that, seems like you're maybe an unhappy person.
Another crazy Karen.
Somebody left their phone. Hey, somebody left their phone. What?
That's my phone.
Excuse me?
That's my phone.
How do I know that's your phone?
I literally put it there like 2 seconds
ago. It's not your phone.
It is my phone.
Well, how do I know that? I just found a phone here, so how do I know that it's yours?
That's weird. That's just weird behavior. That's somebody who's like, I feel like they just like are really waiting for that power moment, you know?
Because we're filming a TikTok.
Okay, I don't even know what that is, but I'm just going to bring this to the checker and you can take it up with them, okay? No. Why is it on right? No, it's not.
Because they were filming a TikTok, like they just said. That's how you know whose phone it is. Because they said, I'm filming a TikTok. And then you look down and you go, oh, yep, this is filming. Like, you just randomly found the phone, lady. First of all, why do you care so much? Second of all, how do I know you're not gonna take it home in your bag? I don't trust you either. Karen, annoying.
Busy would be every single table.
There are 3 servers on, sir. We can only do so much. If you don't like it, you can go somewhere else. Who else is open?
Nobody else. Well, exactly. You know, I'm not going to pay for a meal.
Well, then bye. You're out.
I was gonna say something mean, but I'm gonna keep it to myself, okay? Imagine getting that angry over IHOP.
Cabo, he's gone.
Go. Oh, hey, you son of a you better put that right in my eye. That's some
drama at IHOP, bro.
The guy at the end, drama at IHOP. It's so true though, like that guy needs to freaking chill. What? Also, like he said, you're the only place open. Well, then shut your damn mouth and eat your pancakes, okay? I don't know what you want. Sometimes restaurants are busy, okay? And like, I'm certainly not gonna even attempt to give you good service if you talk to me like that. Guess who's getting no food and a ticket for being rude? I don't know. You obviously can't get a ticket for that, but.
I shouldn't have done it.
She
don't
actually.
She's
wait, what? What is happening? Oh my god. Oh my god.
Run, fool!
Oh boy.
Hey guys, cool. Keep going.
Damn, bro.
Wow, okay, so clearly she is not a fan of skateboarding, guys. What is it with Karens and skateboarding? Like, they just, like, cannot stand it, folks. It literally doesn't mesh, you know? It's like, it retracts from each other, you know? Magnets that, like, go in opposite directions. They can't stand it, you know? Unless they hit your car specifically, I don't see why you have a problem with it, you know? It's like, that is it for me. You hit my car, okay, we got a big problem. You don't, do whatever you gotta do.
Hey. Where is the manager of the store?
What is the manager gonna do? We're both customers.
Shut up.
You shut up.
Shut up, right now.
Bro, who is this bitch talking to, bro?
Huh?
I said, who are you talking to?
Shut up.
I didn't do nothing to you but tell you to stay 6 feet away. Get in line. That's it.
The theme today is that Karens just don't like to wait in line, it seems.
And you're still standing right here looking at me, looking stupid. You want to talk to my mother? Because she'll tell you the same thing.
I don't give a damn about your mother.
Oh, yeah. Okay, well, I don't give a damn about you and what you're talking about.
Shut up.
No, you're cutting all these people.
I'm not cutting.
So why are you still standing here?
Everyone just wants to find a way to get into the middle of the line somehow, and it always goes bad for them. Because people get angry. People don't like people who butt in line. That's just human nature. You know what I mean?
No, totally, dude. Yeah, that is it's a really nice thing to do. Yeah, that's great. That's really great. Yeah, okay, good. Nice, thank you. Did you get a lot of views on that? Get a lot of shares? Get a lot of likes? A lot of comments? Yeah, I hope it was worth it, dude, because, like, that's just...
sarcastic.
Yo, like, literally, what if this crashed the plane? Like, I'd be worried about that. I'd be like, dude, my toilet paper is gonna get, like, clogged in their plumbing on the plane, and it's gonna cause a problem, and then with the whole thing's gonna go down. Like, what if that actually happened?
Keep watching.
You literally killed everyone on the plane because of your dumb toilet paper thing. I mean, I hope that wasn't the case, but like...
still, don't do that.
Get out. Get out. No. 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 No, 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 no. Wow. There are very few things in this life that would warrant having to take somebody and physically eject them from an airplane, but this could be one of them, guys. Like, at this point, I go, all right, get up. Here's your parachute. There's the door. Best of luck to you, because I cannot be dealing with something like that, man.
So my neighbor...
cops called on me. Love it.
Because my kid's Barbie car is beeping.
Dude, really?
This is just the most hilarious thing I've ever seen in my life.
Over a Barbie car? I mean, if that's actually what's happening, that's pretty... it's pretty stupid, dude. For a Barbie car? I always wanted one of those. Not a Barbie one, but the boy one.
You can't make this stuff up.
Maybe a Barbie one.
Barbie car, you guys. A Barbie car.
Do those things even make noise though? Like, it's just like the... and it drives along, but is there like a... are there horns on them now or something? Because the ones when I was a kid, they didn't have horns. When I was a kid, they didn't have horns on them. They just went. They just did things. I always wanted one, but I was always a little bit more rotund than some of the other boys. I was a little bit bigger, so I could, you know, if I sat it, it would just... you know, it wouldn't go. That's a sound I make when cars don't go good. Guys, sounds stupid here sometimes. Calling the cops for that, dude, you know cops. Say what you will about law enforcement, but like, you know when they get a call from dispatch, they're just, all right, I'm going, you know what I mean? But you gotta do your job.
Oh my God, we have somebody trying to crash the goddamn plane again. Yeah, here we go. This is it. Like, this is the end now. I'm like, oh my God. Like, red alert. Like, imagine if, like, literally, like, noises start going off in the plane. I'm like, oh my gosh. Like, yeah, that's why we don't do this, because, like, this is stupid and, like, you're just ruining. Next time somebody needs to go and, like, go to the bathroom, what if somebody's dealing with, like, serious diarrhea right now? Like, what if that, think about that, if that was you. Then you get there and there's no toilet paper and you're just in this, like, it would be horrible. Like, don't make somebody go through that.
They gave me trying to clear that cloth. I don't know.
What have I been saying? What have I been saying?
Clear the clock, which affects all the other toilets, and they are looking to see what kind of relief they can do with that. Hopefully somebody will be showing up here shortly.
Okay, well, listen, I really feel for this individual if they had to just use the bathroom and, like, they had some, you know, they had some bad meat or something like that earlier in the day, and it's just like, what are you gonna do? Like, you have to use it, you know, and you just happen to clog it, like, that would be the worst.
Okay, getting arrested on live stream.
We're good. No, I'm parking. I'm on TikTok Live.
Nope,
she's drunk. She's a little drunk.
Can you come out and step out the door for me for a second?
I swear to God.
If you listen for 5 seconds, it's gonna go a lot. Although I gotta say, from somebody who knows what, as Chris says, I spent a night in the drunk tank. I didn't.
I understand that. I just need you to step out of the door for me, please.
Whoa, guys.
Whoa.
Yeah, well, why don't you step out? Step out.
Gosh.
Chris isn't wrong. I may or may not know my way around a bottle of whatever's in your cupboard there. I gotta say, she sounds like she's a little inebriated. It's either that or she's got a really thick accent, but it sounds like she might have had a few. She's in the car. The car sounds like it's on with the radio. Those things don't add up. That's not a good look. It's not gonna look good in court. So it's best you just follow procedure there.
Well, I'll wait for security.
Okay, then go ahead and wait over here, ma'am.
No, I'm gonna keep going until I get to my security. Did someone pee? Okay, thank you. You can continue to do your job, ma'am. Go back up there to the gate and do your job, please. Okay, ma'am. Your job is done. I'm gonna wait on security. You already called them. You have nothing else to say to me. Wow, I hate you.
Yo, at first I thought someone peed because we were just like looking at the puddle on the ground. I was like, uh-oh, what did Karen do?
It doesn't matter. What's your name? Okay, thanks, Maggie. Have a good day.
Ma'am, I need your number.
I don't know.
Can I see your number, please?
No, you cannot.
Your scene number,
no, you cannot.
Ma'am?
No, you cannot.
Yeah, they can, actually.
Yes, but I have to touch the security. Ma'am, go wait for security.
We'll go wait for them. Figure it out.
Okay. But, nah, she was just being rude about her seat and her carry-on and blah, blah, blah. Like, seen this movie before. I hate it.
Something I like to do when I'm bored on an airplane is annoy people. This is what I do. I go to Google, find a picture of a hot dog, and save it. This looks just perfect. Okay. Then I go to my airdrop and find as many people as I can sitting around me and proceed to send them a random picture of a hot dog.
Alright, you know what? That's not so bad. I can live with that one. Like, that's a lot better than the freaking toilet paper. Like, that's kind of funny, you know?
Some will decline it, but don't worry, you can redo it. If your name's Emily, Caitlin, or Kat and you were flying from DC to Pittsburgh and got a picture of a hot dog, that was me.
It's a hot dog, like, so you gotta do it like a few times. You gotta do it like 3 or 4 times in the flight, you know? It's like, it's just like different things, it's like slowly escalating. Like, maybe it's one hot dog, then it's half eaten hot dog. I don't know, but we could take a place. We could definitely take a place. That one's kind of funny. I like it.
Be sure to give him a kiss on the forehead.
Get the fuck out of here, right now! Get out!
I don't really know what I just heard. There was a lot of screaming, a lot of foots clapping on the pavement there. I don't really know what's going on in that one.
Hey, my peace is being disturbed, officer. I'd like to file a report.
The peace is being disturbed. I'm gonna also go by the rule of she's the one that's not very calm. He's the one that is calm, so he might be the one that's the. It's hard to say. It's hard. I need more context on that one. Hard to say.
Aww. I love him. I love him. He's so cute. I'm kind of shocked, actually, that he's on there. I didn't think that would be allowed to have a dog like that. Like, I think you'd have to... I don't know how it works with animals. I've never flown with an animal before, but I've also never seen an animal on an airplane that I've been on before either. So comment down below, how does it work with animals? I didn't think that he'd be allowed to be there, but that is so cute anyways. I love it. Okay. Dude, okay, first off, I don't actually believe him here. I don't believe him because it's like, there's no way in hell they took off, they landed the plane, never checked the bathroom, and then took off again. You're kidding. There's just absolutely no way that that happened. And you also would not be able to stay in the flight for that long. Like, think about it, somebody's gonna have to use the bathroom eventually on the next flight. I don't actually buy him doing this, and frankly, if he did do this, then that sucks, because like, people actually need to use the washroom, dude, so. Get out of here.
Can you just keep it shut, please? Can you just keep it shut, please? I'm trying to sleep.
I want it down.
Just keep it shut.
I want it up. I'd like to see where I'm going.
I called the intendant. You're being ridiculous.
Oh.
Good.
Oh, leave this man, this poor man alone. Get out of here, lady.
Let it down.
No.
Put it down.
No.
You don't own this plane.
Well, you don't either.
Don't touch me. That's assault.
Get out of here. He's just trying to look out the window, for God's sake. You know, and she's just like, you don't own the plane. And then she's reaching over into what is his seat. That's his seat, AKA his window. He had to pay extra to have that window seat, as did you. And if you didn't want this, like, you sit in the other, you literally buy a ticket in the other seat. I wouldn't be able to handle somebody like that. I would almost want them to sit next to me just so I could tell them off. You know, it'd be that level for me.
All right, I just want to make sure you understand that, because you're being recorded and you're saying that you understand that.
I understand that, ma'am. What's your name?
Craven Swan.
Swan.
Like a bird.
Officer Swan, thank you very much.
Yes. Fine. But listen here. You come back out here and start touching your equipment, you are going to go to jail. I don't care if you agree or you disagree.
So I think that, for me, that's the number one. I think for me, out of any Karen video or anything that I do here on Central, like anything I see, for me, the number one is people trying to do their jobs and Karens or somebody getting in the way. That, to me, is just the worst. Like, above anything, that is like number one, my biggest pet peeve.
It's not your job to come out here and tell them what they can and can't chop down.
Thank you.
They're just trying to do their job. It's Monday morning.
Monday morning.
Only Monday, man. It's only Monday, man.
This is a society. We gotta do our part. The men job on their job. They're trying to get their freaking job done, man. Like, they're just, you wake up, it's Monday morning, you get out of bed and you know what he wants to. It's crack of dawn, you go to work, you're trying to cut down a tree, and now a lady's trying to tell you you can't cut down a tree. And the cop said it. She's like, hey, you come out again, you're going to jail. Simple. It's as simple as that. You come out of there again, you're getting arrested. Just let the guy cut down the fucking tree. I said fucking, but that's okay. Sometimes you can swear. I got mad. Let him cut down the tree, man. Let him do his job. Let the delivery guy deliver his package. Let's keep her going. Are we throwing fists? We might be throwing fists, yo. I'm ready, buddy. Whoa! Yeah, I don't know what that was. It looks like it might be Australia or England is my city. It might be one of those places, judging by the license plates. And the cop doesn't have a blam blam, so I'm gonna say that maybe that's London or something like that, isn't it? Sometimes we break down in society, though. Sometimes she's having a mental health moment. Oh, we're doing this. She's shaking. She's doing the Donkey Kong thing from Smash Brothers. She's doing she's doing the charge up, you know what I mean? Donkey Kong, Smash Brothers, one of my favorite games, and he does the charge punch and he gets it ready, and then he just gives you one of those, buddy. Just gives you one of those. Sometimes we go a little nuts, but there's no reason we gotta start throwing Donkey Kong punches. I think that's a rule. You can put that up there, like, my rules. Don't sniff your own farts, and then don't act like Donkey Kong. That's a good one. That's a really good one. Unless you're actually playing Smash Bros. That's a great one. Someone should fight me in a Smash tournament. I love that game. Let's have some fun.
I want to have an assigned seat on a flight. I was supposed to be at work. If there's nothing at 9:15, we have to stand by the whole damn day. Our flight was supposed to leave in 10 minutes and we missed our flight and they got nothing available. All day, you know?
You missed your flight. So.
They advised you to be here 2 hours before departure. You showed up 20 minutes before departure.
But it is your fault. Like, that is, you know, it's just like, it is your fault.
Because the line.
The line takes about 40 minutes, 40 to 50 minutes.
Well, we've never been here before, so I didn't know this, okay? Overbooked. That's ridiculous.
Well.
She tries to blame it on me for not being here in time? I don't think so.
Guys, I'm going to a Blue Jays game later. If I were to show up at the game in like the second inning, I'm not gonna be like, okay, everybody, well, we need to pause this game. We need to go back, do the first inning again because I was late. You guys started without me. No, it's like, I get there and they play, and if I'm not there on time, then I'm gonna miss it. That is just the way of the world, and same goes for the airport.
Okay. Oh my God. Cops. Missed that show. Looks like maybe it's a restaurant. They're about to get kicked out of a restaurant or something. Misbehaving. What?
You're gonna try to lift the heavy ass woman like me with your kind of brain.
Yep. I've seen her do it.
100% certain I can do it.
Don't know what's going on in that one. I am proud to say, proud to say that in my years of existence on the spinning ball that we call planet Earth, I have never had the police called on me. Perhaps, maybe I've been at a few high school parties when I was in high school when I was a younger guy, maybe the police showed up and then I left or something, but I've never had them call on me for being a criminal because I left my Barbie car on. So I'm proud to say that. I haven't been in jail yet. Not yet.
This is the code I'm gonna actually give you. It's 2131.44B. I'm actually going to give you a copy either, of the law today.
Great.
It is primary offense.
Just so you know, also, walking up to a woman's car, you should have pulled me over. You're lucky I didn't have my pepper spray on me because you scared the ever...
The guy just said it like it was, wasn't he? Also, I feel like saying you're going to pepper spray a cop isn't such a good idea. You know what I mean? It's like, well, if you come up next time, I'm going to... I was looking at my pepper spray on me.
If you weren't going through emails, sure. You would probably be more observant.
I'm not trying to be an as a woman, I'm actually shaking right now. I can't believe that you won't even listen.
No, as soon as you said, I pay your salary, we're done.
He's got a point. Sir, he's
I'm
got a point.
To tell you
we are
so
done.
So that you can do your job better.
I've done my job 20 years, and I'm protecting the public from you reading your emails while you drive your car.
Well, that
drive safely now.
You might have the pepper spray. Dude's got the blam blam. He's got the pistol, all right? And you know, it's I wouldn't go that way. Especially in America. I wouldn't go that way. You know what I mean? I don't know. Why just there's ways to deal with this. Get off your phone when you're driving too, man. Come on. What are you doing? I can understand maybe you got to pick it up before like that. Maybe that, but still, like it's 2022, dude. I say Bluetooth. That's so old school. Just connect to your car. I don't know. There's just ways around it, man. Come on. Stop it. Get some help.
Let's go.
ASAP to Nashville with the airplane.
But I can totally see one of those other individuals who just like literally went with the toilet paper down there, them clogging it. And in that case, screw you guys.
Open the door.
Ma'am,
I'm not going to ask you again.
I don't know you. What do you
want? Okay, well, I'm a police officer.
Okay,
you went the wrong way down a one-way street. You don't have a seatbelt on. I'm allowed under federal case law to remove you from the vehicle and have you have your seat in my car.
What are you talking? I just got off work.
Ma'am, I'm going to ask you very nicely to step out of the vehicle, please.
I know.
Okay, I'm going to break your window and drag you out of the car.
You're not.
I'm legally allowed to do that, ma'am.
He's gonna do it. He's just gonna.
Can you open it?
That's
can you?
It.
Open, I need your driver's license, proof of insurance, ma'am. I need your driver's license, proof of insurance, ma'am. Open the door, ma'am. You are under arrest for obstruction of justice. Open the door.
No one can save you now.
What can you say? Man, well, I miss Cops. I miss watching Cops, man. I used to love that show. We used to watch it as a family. Isn't that weird? That's a weird thing to do, isn't it? We also sit down on the couch and watch someone get out of the car, and it's always like, you got something in your car? Nah, man, I got nothing in my car, bro. There's nothing in my car. And then there's something in the car. Well, I made the TV show, so there's probably something in the car. I used to love that show, man. But here, it's just clear, it's concise, it's... If she got out of the car, assuming she's not under the influence of any stuff that she wouldn't be allowed to be, she probably might have not gotten away with it, but she might have gotten off with a warning or maybe a ticket at the most. You know what I mean? If she just got out and said, hey, you know, I made a mistake. It was a stressful day at work, one-way street. Oops-a-daisies. And it looks like no one got hurt. The car's not damaged. So again, it could be just an honest mistake, but now you've taken a little itty bitty thing and you've made it a big thing. So your window's broken and you're going to jail.
Karen was mad because she was not allowed to bring a snow globe on the plane.
Hmm. This is not right. I don't know the rules. I thought that you would be allowed to do that. Like, I thought that you would be allowed to get that because it's like if you're a tourist and you want to get a snow globe and then bring it back home, like, you'd think that that'd be okay. But I guess in this situation, it wasn't. Like, I can understand being like upset and frustrated about that because you just bought that thing, you want to bring it back home. Like, I'd be like, is there any way that I could do this? And then if they say no, then I'm like, all right, well, now it's between the snow globe or getting back home. And at the end of the day, I got to choose getting back home. So, I mean, that one sucks, but like, still, like, don't take it out on them. It is the rules.
Nah, she not. Nah. Not a good time to be doing that. I gotta say, not a fan. Don't support that one.
So that delightful video was filmed in Canada, and I just want the good people to know that licking things in grocery stores is a crime, and you can and likely will be charged with mischief as per the criminal code.
Yeah, you know, there's another thing too where it's like, you go to court for that, you get in trouble, you go to jail, because that's bad, that's heinous. That's pretty heinous. But if you do that and then you go to court for it, and it gets to a point where, you know, you're sitting there, and I don't think there would be a jury for a case like that, unless it just some serious criminal stuff actually happened. Given the way the public and everything in the society works right now, especially with the last 2 years and the sicknesses going around and whatnot, you might get more time actually. You possibly could. It might, you know, the judge is just going, you know, and then that wouldn't be good. So not a good time to be doing that.